Well, let me start by saying I'm very happy to be here in this beautiful city. I always appreciate coming to Thessaloniki because it's a beautiful city. And I'm also happy that we are able to bring business to this region. I mean, last year, as you may remember, we participated as a guest of honor country in the Thessaloniki Fair, and it was an outstanding success. This year, DMCC, Dubai Metal and Commodity Center, is having a roadshow, and that is also a fantastic idea for us as an embassy to bring business and to create awareness for businesses here and businesses in UAE so they can interact with each other. As for the Middle East, I wish you wouldn't have asked me because we are very saddened by what's happening there. Killing and maiming and wars will never bring peace to that region. And so we hope that as UAE always call for de-escalation, security, stability, peaceful means of resolving issues. So this is my feeling on the issue. Well, I can say with confidence that it is ever growing. And I'm not going to talk about the political things. We are strategic partner with Greece, one of few countries that UAEs have strategic partnership agreement with. And so on all aspect, I'm seeing growth continuously going upward. And so that is quite good for any ambassador, really, to see relations strengthening, going from strength to strength. Now, most important thing for me is the economic side, because this is the sustainable aspect of any relations. Political relations, military relations can always, you know, go up and down, but economy is always something to be appreciated by everybody. Businesses appreciate economic relations, governments appreciate economic relations, you know, businesses itself grow and bring return to the economy. And so I'm very happy that relations is growing in all aspects, actually. Mm-hmm. And I can list them for you, but yeah. You know. Well, the paramount benefit from any event that we do here is to create awareness. There is a lot of unclear picture of both sides. And the Greek do not know a lot about UAE and vice versa. So when we participate, and this is truly what I aimed at when I jumped at the idea being the guest of honor at TIFF, the Thessaloniki International Fair, is to create awareness, to bring companies, so Greek businesses get introduced to them, and vice versa. And that's what happened. We are told that out of that big, what I call razzmatazz, or what we would say the greatest show on earth last year, when we had, you know, cultural side to the exhibition, 60 major companies, top companies came, and the best design and decoration of our pavilion number 13. I think people mingled with each other. They got great ideas of what we offer, and our companies also became more aware of what businesses are available here. I think from 800 to 1,000 interaction. Okay, if we get you know, any percentage of that will be great for business growth. I think for the UAE, okay, we have a lot of projects. We're doing energy, tourism, and other investment, technology, etc. But Saloniki is a very, very important area of Greece where it's one of those hidden secrets. Not a lot of people know about it, and I keep promoting it because it's a beautiful, beautiful city. So when you have beautifully positioned city and with all of the, you know, attractions, you will always have tourism as one of the businesses that you should tap on. Okay, tourism, of course, requires aviations, airline flights, etc. So now we are lucky that Aegean and Sky Air Airline have started their flights to UAE, to Dubai, from this month. And that will add to what is already existing, 14 flights of Emirates Airline. I think Etihad Airline also has a good number of flights from Athens. Emirates comes, the only airline that comes from Dubai goes to New York via Athens. And there is one from Dubai and, you know, going back to Dubai. So you have two flights a day. On Emirates only, and then you have, of course, Wizz Air and Al Arabiya and Fly Dubai, fly to the islands during the summer. Mm-hmm. So tourism is very important, and I think if people start discovering the Saloniki, I think they would like it very much, and you will have a huge momentum coming from on the touristic side. You have a lot of other aspects of economy that one should look into. I mean, 2 years ago, I visited Kozani, the western part of Macedonia, and I found that it has a lot of potential, and especially Zafran. And I was told that I am the only Arab country that visited that region. So I was able to explore the beauty of that region, and I saw the marbles, the saffron, and the furs, and a lot of things that can actually be promoted. I think this part of Greece need to be promoted more than what it is in our area. So hopefully that in addition to what we are doing from Athens, Saloniki will also have its share of tourism coming here, and businesses and things. I think these momentum and initiatives we're doing are going to bring results, in my opinion. Well, you know, UAE is in the center of the region and the Gulf. Okay, we always say that our market is 2 billion people. India alone is 1.4 billion of population and beyond. And so we have the largest man-made port in the world, Port Jebel Ali. And I don't want to mention all the tallest towers and the biggest, the best, etc. But we are in the business of connecting world. Dubai, as a business hub, DMCC is located in Dubai. And I think because of their position and the nature of their business, they can only benefit those who get exposed to them. And I think 23,000 members can actually be tapped on by Greek businesses that can link them to businesses of all kinds, from the diamond to coffee, tea, rice, sugar, etc. So the commodities are a lot, and I think the way of doing business there is very advanced. That will make it so easy for any businesses to get linked to them. They are in the business of linking people to people. I think you have to promote it. Very simple. Mm-hmm. It needs to be promoted. It is not promoted. People only know Athens and Mykonos and Santorini. Okay, this city has so many to offer. And I really fell in love with it the minute I arrived here. And so need to be promoted, need to you need to create awareness of what the city offers. Mm-hmm. History and location and, you know, entertainment. It's one of the nicest cities I've seen in Europe, actually. Well, initiatives like this, okay, you get exposed to what we offer and vice versa. So more of these initiatives, more of these roadshows will definitely introduce what we offer to the Greek business people and vice versa. So more of these activities and momentums and roadshows, I think, will definitely help.